First at 5, late breaking news to tell you about in the Robby Albarado trial. Good evening, I'm Rick Van Hoos.
I'm Vicki Dorch. A jury just found the Hall of Fame jockey not guilty of an intentional assault, but guilty of wanton assault. WLKY's Marissa Alter is live at the Hall of Justice with the late breaking details. Marissa?
Vicki, it took jurors a little more than 4 hours to come to this decision. Again, not guilty of the more serious charge, intentional assault, but guilty of wanton assault. That verdict follows 2 days of testimony and this morning's closing arguments from both sides. Here's a little of what jurors heard before they began deliberating.
As a Hall of Fame jockey, Robby Albarado is used to the spotlight, but not this kind of publicity.
Because then the defendant came at her, put her in a bear hug. She said she was on her tippy toes. He forces her down. She falls on her right side. And it hurts. It hurts bad. She testified he kept tugging, pushing, pulling, causing additional injury while they were on the floor.
Albarado's former girlfriend, Carolina Martinez, testified the assault occurred the week of the Kentucky Derby, after she accused him of cheating on her and took his phone. But the defense questioned her credibility and told the court her story changed over time.
Try to separate the drama from the facts here. There's a ton of times she tells hospital, police, her neighbors, her friends, her co-workers, everybody else, we fell.
Albarado's team labeled the case a messy breakup, now playing out in the public because of a heartbroken young woman who wanted revenge.
This is high school boyfriend drama. In her mind, she's been cheated on. She's been used. So she's going to get back.
But prosecutors argued the case is about intentional physical injury.
This is what he did as a result of him assaulting Carolina on April the 30th. This is what he's done, what he did to her. Bruises all over her body.
Jurors listened as the defense emphasized Albarado only wanted his phone back and that he had the right to protect his property.
He's entitled to use whatever physical force he reasonably needs to do to save his phone.
It's unbelievable that they want you to think that he was justified in creating all those bruises, hold him responsible for his actions.
An alternate juror told WLKY if she were in the deliberation room, she'd find Albarado not guilty.
I would base that almost completely on Ms. Martinez's testimony herself. She described the events that happened, and this case was really all about whether or not he purposely injured her.